Hi everyone, I'm Brandon Case. In today's video, we are going to take a deep dive into Ouroboros Samoseka, the consensus mechanism used to secure MENA protocol, and how it unites people all around the world. Ouroboros Samoseka is a proof-of-stake consensus mechanism based off of Cardano Protocol's Ouroboros. Essentially, it's a different consensus mechanism used from Bitcoin, and like all proof-of-stake protocols, requires much less computing power than Bitcoin's proof-of-work. If you're not sure what proof-of-work or proof-of-stake is, check out this video that we linked to below before diving into Ouroboros. Think of proof-of-stake like a game of darts. The network throws darts at a dartboard broken up into a pie chart based on stake, and the dart can land anywhere with equal likelihood. The bigger the stake, the larger the area on the dartboard, and thus the greater likelihood of being hit with a dart. When your stake is hit with a dart, you can produce a block. Of course, people's hold on a stake is constantly changing, so the distribution of stake on the dartboard needs to change too. Now, let's figure out when we redraw our dartboard and throw darts. Every 14 days, in Ouroboros, this is called an epoch, we redraw the board or recalculate the stake distribution. Each epoch in MENA consists of a number of slots, and each slot is when a dart is thrown. As of mainnet launch, each slot lasts for 3 minutes. And an epoch in MENA currently includes 7,140 slots, which takes around 14 days. With MENA, there is no minimum requirements for staking. Anyone can either stake themselves or delegate their stake to someone else. Stake distribution is based on the balances at the last block 2 epochs prior. Most precisely, it's on whatever the snark workers have finished snarking at the last blocks 2 epochs prior. And you can see the Snarker Place video to learn more. So if the current epoch is 5, then the state of the blockchain is at the last block of the 3rd epoch, and that's what's used to calculate the stake distribution. Now let's investigate what is equivalent to throwing a dart in Ouroboros. It's the opportunity to produce a block for a slot that's determined by a verifiable random function. This is a random function that needs a private key to run and can be verified with a public key. Executing a VRF is Ouroboros' mechanism for throwing the dart. If your dart hits your slice of the dartboard, then you can create a block. Hitting that part of the dartboard is equivalent to checking that your VRF output is greater than your fraction of the stake. Using VRFs, the dart throw that each block producer performs is secret and not revealed until their block is shared. Remember that only the holder of the private key can determine the VRF output, so only the block producer knows when they're going to produce a block. This allows block producers to secretly compute when they're going to produce the block without anyone else on the network knowing until the block producer actually produces the block. This improves overall security, as it is impossible for a bad actor to know and target the next block producer at a certain slot with a targeted denial of service attack, an attack where one or more machines tries to overload another. This also means that multiple block producers can be selected for the same slot, further reducing the likelihood of targeting the correct block producer for an attack. If multiple block producers produce a valid block for the same slot, this will produce a short-range fork that follows the typical consensus rules to select the longest chain. However, if there are only equal length forks, then a node will either accept the first seen block or replace it if an alternative is seen with a larger VRF output. In order for the network to believe a given VRF, the randomness for them is carefully computed from Ouroboros' epochs to make sure malicious influence is not possible under reasonable assumptions about usage, no 51% attacks, etc. Putting all this together, the way that these VRFs work on MENA implies that if most of the stake is participating, we expect a block on the main chain, not a fork, around every 4 minutes. Let's consider what is different between a recent version of Cardano's Ouroboros and MENA's Ouroboros, Samoseka. In Cardano's, long-range forks look at the entire path on the chain to determine which chain is real. Since MENA is a succinct blockchain, this won't work. We can't check history. Ouroboros Samoseka's main innovation is to replace the long-range chain checking with a minimum density function. It's essentially a single number that stands in for checking all the blocks on a chain. A valid chain will always have a higher minimum chain density. Any node, as a result, is naturally going to follow the chain that has the highest density, even if it isn't the longest. Though this change seems minor, it's actually major. We can now achieve consensus with no long-term history. Proof-of-stake is an energy-efficient method for achieving consensus, and Ouroboros is the first provably secure proof-of-stake protocol. MENA builds on top of Ouroboros to create Ouroboros Samoseka, a provably secure proof-of-stake protocol that combines the best aspects from every iteration of Ouroboros to deliver a proof-of-stake mechanism that can resolve long-range forks without requiring history or risking the centralization of relying on third parties to provide fork information. Ouroboros Samasika utilizes VRFs for selecting winning block producers, which nicely secures against denial-of-service attacks and provides scalability. With the power of Ouroboros Samasika, Mina is able to deliver highly secure, scalable, and efficient proof-of-stake blockchain protocol. So that's it for this video. Please give it a like if you found it enlightening and follow at Mina Protocol on Twitter for more tech updates. Do you have a better understanding of how Mina's Ouroboros Samasika consensus mechanism works? Drop me your comments down below, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next video.